that is right in front of you. In the last class, I have introduced trigonometry. I have tried to clarify the common confusion in your mind while doing trigonometry with a right angle triangle regarding perpendicular base and hypotenuse. Today we will discuss, in continuation of that class, that there are three terms, sine, cos and tan, primarily three terms, sine theta, cos theta, tan theta. Maybe these are sounding Hebrews to you, because first time you are hearing this. So let me explain what are these. I told you earlier that trigonometry always deals with right angle triangles. Say A, B, C and right angle at B. So this is perpendicular, this is base and this is hypotenuse. You already know this. Now the ratio between perpendicular and hypotenuse, ratio means we can write in this way, is sine theta. Remember, we are working with this angle, angle ACB, this is theta. Cos theta is base by hypotenuse. And tan theta is perpendicular by base. Now you see one thing, students, one interesting thing, in your book you will get the formula of tan theta is sine theta by cos theta. Let us prove this. You see, sine theta by cos theta, perpendicular by hypotenuse, again by base by hypotenuse. Hypotenuse, hypotenuse will be cancelled. So it is becoming, you see, perpendicular by base, which I have written here, tan theta is equal to perpendicular by base. Soon in the next episode, we will discuss what is sine theta, what is cos theta, what is tan theta, and what is the use of trigonometry. Why we will learn this? So let us call it a day. Have a good day.